The final design I'd like to talk about today is the hygienic, also called sanitary, pontic. This shape is loosely known as a fish belly. It can also be modified to shape the gingival portion concave to resemble sort of an archway between the retainers. So, take for instance the pontic design on this 3-unit BioTemp bridge. And when I turn it around, you can see the appearance of a ridge lap pontic design. It's also called a saddle ridge lap because it looks like a riding saddle that's worn over the back of a horse. It's a fairly aesthetic design from any angle, but its major flaw is its lack of cleansability, and it often results in irritated tissue. In fact, most dentists that I've talked to about this tell me that they absolutely do not use saddle ridge lap pontics in their practice, nor do they even consider them as an option. An option that is more commonly used instead of the full saddle ridge lap pontic design is what is known as a modified ridge lap. This pontic is shaped so that the saddle laps over the buckle side only. The shape and size of the ridge and restoration dictate the lingual design, but it does curve in to leave the lingual ridge exposed. This is fairly aesthetic and more cleansable than the full ridge lap. So, let's take a look at a few more options at your disposal. The ovate pontic design is ideal for the anterior. However, it's not limited and can be used for posteriors because it is highly aesthetic and low maintenance. This design creates a bit of a depression or an indentation in the residual tissue ridge so that it mimics the shape of a natural root and crown. Now, the pontic looks like it's growing out of the gum tissue and just not resting on top of it. Playing off of the shape of the ovate design, a conical pontic, also called egg-shaped, bullet-shaped, or even heart-shaped, has only one point of contact at the center of the residual ridge, but it does not depress into it as the ovate design usually will. It should be made as convex as possible, and this makes it easy for the patient to clean. This design is recommended more for replacing mandibular posterior areas where aesthetics are less of a concern. The final design I'd like to talk about today is the hygienic, also called sanitary, pontic. This design is easily cleansable and ideal for the health of the tissue, especially new surgical sites. However, it is not at all aesthetic. It could lead to food entrapment and can become annoying to the tongue over time. This shape is loosely known as a fish belly. It can also be modified to shape the gingival portion concave to resemble sort of an archway between the retainers. This allows for increased connector size and decreased stress during load bearing. These differences make it seem like the hygienic design contradicts itself, from concave to convex and fish bellies to fixed arcs. The design parameters can become elaborate and even confusing. Keep in mind that you are doing your lab tech and your patient the best service by specifically addressing these important issues. Doctors and assistants should all run through a mental checklist of 4 very basic standards of design. First, the tissue surface of the pontic should be shaped for ease of cleaning. Second, pontics should never have positive pressure on the underlying tissue unless they are meant exclusively for provisional shaping. Third, pontics and connectors must be built to withstand occlusal forces. Finally, pontics should restore aesthetics.